huge number of UC organizations are working on that. I can give you an example, and this example is in fact quoted by the Western media, largely in the US media, that there are 872 hate groups operating only in the United States, and FBI is in fact giving this report. Now these groups are in fact operating to give media that kind of stuff which are capable of creating hatred towards Muslims and Islam. So who are they? Why they are doing that? Because of this kind of, you see, ideological clash they would like to create in the minds of the people. So that's why, of course, they would be taking help of the media, creating that kind of thing, or they are playing up things in a way which are capable of creating chaos and disturbances in the minds of the people. Anything bad happens, they try to, in fact, immediately attach with some Muslim is there, or somebody who is a radicalized extremist Islamist is there. Media discourses are now changed. Islam is everywhere being used as a synonymous to extremism and intolerance in the Western media. So this is not capricious. This is not which is happening all of a sudden. No, there are very organized efforts behind them. Very big organizations are working on that. That's why it has now become, Islamophobia has become now an industry. And that industry is in fact paying people a lot of money. You might have come across some of the people, those who are working in that and very famous in the West. What do? They immediately say something negative about Muslims and Muslims' religious personalities. And there are a huge number of people that are following them. So they increase their followers. And once the number of followers are increased, of course, their income is being increased. So this kind of thing is, you see, going on over there. So media is very heavily being controlled by them. And one more thing that I would like to say over here, that might appear to be somehow displeasing for some other people, that those who are in fact doing that, most of them are in fact Jews. So this is the second reason that I am in fact giving. One is in fact the rise of the right-wing parties, are right-wing, those who are somehow negative towards the other religions, and especially the Islam as a religion, to be spreading in their societies. And the second important thing is that a huge number of funding is involved, and that is very organized in some of the states, and some of the very organized institutional setups are there which are in fact pouring in. The third thing very important is that now the polity in the Western world is, of course, that has now a very clear dividing line. You have might noticed it, that in some of the countries, for instance, United States is taking lead into that. Those who are against Muslims and against Islam and saying something like that and saying, issuing a lot of statement, for instance, the Trump administration and all the people, those who are in fact now the associates and are helping Trump successfully run his administration. You just look at them, that who they are. They are very polemical towards Islam and Muslims. So they have succeeded, or you can say that they had a huge triumphs just because of it, that they are anti-Islam or anti-Muslim. So some of the countries in Europe are also now following the same pattern, because they say this is something which could be very easily be sold to the market. They can earn the huge vote bank by saying something against Islam and Muslim. I just quote one example. Angela Merkel, the Chancellor of Germany, she was once used to be saying it. I mean, in our first election, she was saying that Muslims are part of our societies, and anything that happens to them is in fact considered to be something that is happening to every German. I mean, this is the slogan that she used to have in her first election. Now she is going for the second election, and now she is in fact following whatever was followed by or said by Trump, saying something against the Muslims. That's why now she is saying that if a Muslim has to live in our society, they have to live peacefully and they have to respect our values instead of installing their own value system in German societies. How can now she be, of course, different? I mean, she was very different than what she used to be in her first election campaign than what is she appears to be now. The reason behind is that she's thinking about it, that this is something that can easily be bought and sold out in the market. So this is something now going on. And same thing you can observe in the UK politics as well, in the French politics as well. I mean, this is something very strange to quote and to say and to share it with you, that there are more than 70% of the people, those who are behind the bars in France, they are in fact Muslims, or anything that has been done in shape of extremism or suspect terrorists or these kind of things. So they are Muslims and behind the bars in the France jails.